Ever needed to get alerts based on specific log events in Google Cloud but weren't sure how to do so? In this video, we'll crack the code and discover how to easily set this up. While this same approach works for an extremely wide variety of application scenarios, basically for anything using cloud logging, we'll use the example of a Kubernetes pod that's generating error logs. We'll then alert, perhaps via Slack, email, or SMS, on those error logs. We'll do that setup with you so you can have a from-scratch proof of concept in no time. Cloud Operations automatically ingests those pod logs in a default Kubernetes cluster scenario. In the case that you're using a non-cloud logging application setup, which is basically just custom workloads on Compute Engine VMs, you'll need to set up an operations logging agent to get those logs centralized. Okay, let's get our hands dirty and set this up in Google Cloud. First stop on this journey, the Kubernetes Engine page, where we'll activate the API. Once that's all set up, we'll create a cluster. We have options here, standard or autopilot. If we opt for autopilot, cloud operations-based logging is mandatory. If we instead go with the standard cluster, we have more flexibility with the configuration, including the ability to disable that logging altogether. In our case, we want the logging, so either option will suffice and we'll proceed with an autopilot cluster. In short order, that cluster will be all ready for a workload deployment. To create a workload, we'll leverage the Cloud Shell and authenticate with the cluster. For this demonstration, we'll run an Nginx image. We'll expose that Nginx service so we can communicate with it via a public IP. Now let's delve into the logs for that pod. Imagine that we want to alert on 404 errors. This will be a nice option for demonstration's sake, but beware, you'll get tons of alerts if you do this on a real public website. Navigating to our workloads in the Google Kubernetes Engine service, we'll drop into the Nginx pod and tiptoe our way to the container logs. Getting to the logs from the workload itself is a fast pass for log query creation. If you go straight to the Log Explorer page, keep in mind that you'll need to do more manual filter setup. From here, click on the error log and select Show Similar Entries. And voila, a new field in our log query. The regular expression that it recommends is a bit intense and too specific, so let's trim it up a bit. Interestingly enough, we had another 404 when the browser automatically attempted to fetch the favicon for the Nginx homepage. Regardless, we've successfully honed in on the type of log that should trigger an alert. Let's copy this text and then venture down to log-based metrics. Here, we'll set up a metric named Nginx 404. This will be a counter metric, making units necessary. Just bear in mind that depending on your specific use case, you may need to make this log query a tad more flexible. For example, monitoring a single pod might fall short if you're using a Kubernetes deployment or stateful set. Or perhaps if you're using a multi-cluster, multi-regional deployment model, you'll need to dismiss the cluster name from the query. Anyway, let's quickly sanity check the metric details and then create an alert from this metric. Here we need to decide the specific circumstances that would ring the alarm. Let's propose that in any given minute, we'll tally the 404 errors, and if we have one or more new 404s, the sirens should blare. We also need to select a notification channel, or in simpler terms, the method by which we'll distribute alerts. Let's insert an email here, for instance. You could also rope in other integrations like Slack or webhooks. After choosing the notification channel, let's christen the alert 404s on Nginx. With everything in order, let's put our new alert system to the test. Within a minute or two, we should spot an alert in our email. Lo and behold, we have our Nginx 404 alert activating. We can dive into the incident details and related logs within the Google Cloud console. Since this is a standard Google Cloud metric, there's a world of possibility for us. We can chart these over time and weave them into other sectors of the Google Cloud Operations Suite. Please leave any thoughts, questions, or comments in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.